How do you dry wet laundry? You dry with a dryer? Or maybe a clothes rack? Why don't we save this stuff and create a closet with an integrated drying function? We will build up a prototype to see what's possible. Enjoy the video after the intro. Hello and welcome to the project of building a highly efficient drying closet. We will create this project as a mini series of videos. One video to build the closet, one for the testing and efficiency improvements, and the last one for the series closet. Let's start with a general overview of the idea of the project. We want to create a space for clothes that is smaller than a closet in combination with a commercial dryer, should use less energy and also dry the laundry more gently. The basic frame is similar to a normal closet. In addition, there are now flow channels on the side, on the floor and on the ceiling. A dehumidifier and a fan are also installed in the side duct. Based on the components, an airflow is generated that transports dry air to the clothes and sucks in moist air from below. Sounds good for you? Let's give it a try. Let's start with the frame for the drying closet. We use for the prototype easily accessible materials like spruce and fir from the hardware store. Just because it's a prototype, we focus on practical use versus the design. In order not to waste our time, I will ramp up certain sections. Feel free to put your questions in the comments. We will come back to you. Let's start building up the main body. The next step is to integrate the fan into the closet. We need to make sure that the fan in the duct is sealed on all sides so that a negative pressure is created under the fan to suck in the moist air from the closet. The fan we use is an industrial fan with 700 cubic meters per minute, but you could also take a different one, just make sure it fits into your flow channel. So that no volume flow can flow directly between the plate and the fan, we have also glued a yellow seal directly onto the edge of the fan. We sealed the edges of the board with 3 mm thick ArmaFlex. To ensure that we do not suck in any outside air from outside the cabinet, we have also sealed the stand area with ArmaFlex. We use a 2 mm thick plastic film to seal the air ducts from the outside and still have a good view of the components. The next step is to drill the holes for the air inlets and outlets in the air ducts above and below the clothes. To get a homogeneous air distribution over the entire interior space, a total of 48 holes were drilled in both panels. In order to reduce flow losses when flowing through the bore holes, the edges of the holes were given a radius of 1 cm. Now that the floor and ceiling panels are back in place, it's time for a brief overview of the electrical system. We use different sensors to track temperature, humidity, current, and voltage in the system. Here you see a combined BMP280 sensor from Bosch. Just for information, we will create a second video where we will explain all the sensors in detail and how we calibrated them. Just for your information, there is no need to install the measurement equipment for private use. You just need 2 sockets for the fan and the dehumidifier. Let's move on to the next component. So that on the one hand we want to protect our electrical components and on the other hand we want to catch dust, we build a catch net for dust under our clothes. To do this, we build a frame and then attach a filter mat to it. To close the closet at the front, we use a simple roller blind from IKEA. In the closet we are supposed to hang our clothes like on a clothes horse. To do this, we welded two frames and equipped them with a clothesline. For convenient equipping of the cabinet, we have connected the metal frames to the cabinet using drawer pullouts. I hope you enjoyed the video and look forward to the next video. We are currently testing the cabinet under various conditions in order to achieve the best possible efficiency. If you have any questions or comments, please write them below. Have a nice day and see you soon. Your Engineerds.